Hello, I'm here for round one on the draw, and this hand is not fantastic. It lacks a one drop, but it's still definitely good. I have some early plays, and then on turn three I get to play a 5-5 Knight of Reliquary. If we're playing against Pod or Jund, it should be an interesting matchup. It's probably not favorable, but definitely winnable. Especially with four scavenging ewes and the amount of removal we have, I'm fine playing against Pod. Looks like it is Pod. I'm going to play one of my creatures this turn. Think that it should be the scavenging ooze. Since I have so many lands, I don't want to take too much damage. I can just fetch out my basics and be fine later. Okay, birthing pod. That might be difficult to beat. On the other hand, my opponent is at 13, and I have a Gorkland Rampager and Lightning Helix in hand. So, one option is to just kill his voice and attack him for 3. See, the 3 drops he can get are Sphinx, Witness, Pontiff, and Witness. I might have said that already. I think that it's better to just cast Knight and attack. My opponent shouldn't have a way to kill it this turn unless my opponent has an Abrupt Decay or Shriek Maw in hand. So I think that it will be quite potent if it lives. Next turn I'll grow it to a 6-6, and then maybe use Gorkland Rampager and kill my opponent. My opponent's already at 11, so I think we definitely have a chance. Yeah, and it's good that I played the ooze instead of the Tarmogoyf because I got in an extra 1 damage. Okay, my opponent's paying 2 life, gets a token, and probably Kitchen Sphinx. Okay, instead my opponent got Eternal Witness to return the voice. Oh, never mind, to return a land. Maybe my opponent's just casting a Sphinx from the hand. If my opponent doesn't kill my knight, I feel good. But if my knight gets killed, I am a little bit concerned. Oh, Spike Feeder. Interesting. Path was a good draw. I will not deny that. Well, I feel like I'm going to win this game. My hand is just so good. But I should be careful. Alright, I think the best play is to just play land and then attack without casting any spells. If my opponent blocks in a certain way, I can just kill them with Gorkland Rampager and Lightning Helix. And if I'm not able to kill my opponent, I should be able to at least blow my opponent out by killing all the creatures. Okay, my opponent has only blocked the scavenging ooze. So I can grow my knight to a 6-6, Gorkland it to a 10-10, and then my opponent will gain 4 life, go to 12, and then I helix to kill. So that was pretty easy. Gorkland on the knight, green, Hopefully my opponent doesn't have Slaughter Pact, but I'm not going to play around that. Okay, my opponent did indeed gain 4 life, and then goes to 2, and then I'll cast Lightning Helix. It's a nice little turn 4 kill, even without a 1 drop. Okay, so against Pod, I'm very happy with the way I built my deck to have 4 Scavenging Ooze. And then, apart from that, I can add Journey to Nowhere and Dismember. I would love to have a card like Olivia Voldaren or Linvala, but I currently did not include those. One mistake a lot of people make is they bring in removal for Pod, like Stony Silence, when they're playing Zoo. But from my perspective, when I played Pod, I would even board out some Birthing Pods against Zoo, because it costs a lot of life. I could consider bringing in Torpor Orb. It does stop a lot of cards. So I'll probably bring in Journey, Dismember, and Torpor Orb. And I can cut Boros Charm, and I definitely want this removal. The Gore Clans are great. I'm gonna be on the draw. I could just cut a land. Okay, I'll cut a singular Lightning Helix. Alright, I'll submit this for game 2.